Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at the LPI Level 1 exam 102 and localization of your Linux system. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you may follow me at theurbanpenguin, and on Facebook, you'll be able to find and like my page again as The Urban Penguin. For the demonstration, we'll be using SUSE Linux Enterprise 11, and you can see I'm at the command line as the root user. Every time that we store a file or we write to a log file in Linux, we write with UTC time. Doesn't matter whether we're in the UK or within the US, we're always writing with UTC time. So if I take a look at a file here, stat, and then we'll look at, let's say, etc hosts. It doesn't really matter what file, but when we start looking at the access, modify, and change time, the date stamp stored within the file is always going to be in UTC time. Even in the UK, when we're in summertime, the value that we're going to place within the file or within the log, the date stamp is always going to be the universal time coordinate. The way we see it, though, is always going to be converted to our local time. So our Linux system has to know what our local time is and the offset to UTC time. For this, then, we'll take a look at the file in the etc directory, local time. This then links through to the correct time zone information. And of course, there's many ways to skin a cat, and we'll see, depending on the program you'll use, will depend on the time zone conversion that we use. So mainly we're using the etc local time. This might be a regular file, or it might easily be as well a symbolic link. Very often it's better if it's symbolically linked. When I look at this file, it's just been copied across from the USR directory, and we can see that it's a regular file. I can, of course, delete this file and create a symbolic link, and it will work in exactly the same way, but at least it's then giving me information about the time zone that I'm currently in. So if I create a symbolic link using ln minus s, and then we're going to link from USR forward slash share forward slash and then zone info. Of course, we have to know the time zone that we're in, but it's going to be capital E for Europe and then capital LO for London. And then we'll link it, of course, to the local file, local time. So I'm already in the etc directory, so I don't need to put the path through. But now when I go through and do a long listing of this file, I will be able to see the time zone that we are currently in. So in many respects, I think this is probably one of the best ways to set up your time zone. But as you saw, that meant deleting the original file if it wasn't linked. Another way just to quickly see the time zone is to issue the date command, and it will show the time zone. So saying that I'm currently in Greenwich Mean Time, in summer it would show BST for British Standard Time. However, there are always more than one ways to skin this proverbial cat, and unfortunately in Linux, some applications will read from different files. On Fedora and Red Hat and SUSE based systems, we can read from forward slash etc forward slash sysconfig and the clok file. And that quite simply has the time zone embedded to it. We see Europe, London, and of course, then that's pointing through to the same location, the USR share time zone, and then Europe and London. If you're on a Debian-based system or Ubuntu, then you would get it from etc time zone. So we do have to configure both if we are changing the time zone. Here, I never actually changed my time zone. I just deleted the time zone file and created a new symbolic link. But either way, we should be able to see that it's relatively straightforward and simple to be able to configure your time zone. Bear in mind though, if you are using a graphical system, there's almost bound to be graphical tools that will allow this to be set. We all know those users who we say are working in a different time zone. Well, we can say at least with Linux that could be true. We can set an individual's time zone using a variable TZ in capital T and capital Z. So this might be done at the command line as required, so we can see different times of the world, or we might do it within a login script if that user permanently needs a different time zone set. Let's just take a look at it. We'll export the variable to make it available to subshells. So we'll go export TZ equals. And one of the easiest ways to do it is with the file name format. So if we're going to use the file name format, we preface the file name with a colon. And then we just go through to USR, share, zoneinfo. And we'll go into America, and then we can say set Dominica. With this set, now when I look at the date command, we can see that we're seeing it's 9:31 on American Standard Time, AST. If we wanted to change this through to a different time zone, let's put in Denver. So we should see now that our date is showing Mountain Time, so 6:30 in the morning. So this becomes a very easy way that we can give separate clocks to our users, if you like. Say this might be done through scripts at the command line, it might be done at the command line if our users are aware of how they can set it, or you might put it through a login script or profile so it sets it every time we log in. You're also going to have to be aware of, for the exam and in real life, information about your locale setting. If I go through and run the command at the moment, so if I just type locale, we can see then that currently I've set up to ENGB and UTF-8. But what is the locale? We can kind of get an idea by the way the variables are set up that it affects the way telephone numbers are formatted, the way the paper size is formatted for printers, the way money is displayed, the way the time and numerals are displayed. In the UK, we would separate our thousands with a comma, whereas in Eastern Europe, they would use dots to separate the thousands. So all of this makes up part of our locale. I could use locale and minus A to display all of the locales on the system. But if I send it through to grep, and if we search for EN underscore GB, that as well as the UTF-8, we can see that I also have an ISO standard. The ISO standard I see is 8859. We then just have a modifier at the end, 15, to set it a little bit more geared towards the UK. It used to be that the ISO standard was the one that was used mainly, but more so now we're seeing implementations and most systems using UTF-8. If we have problems with our text editors perhaps not supporting the correct character sets, then we might be able to convert an 8859 file to UTF-8. And the tool that we would use for this would be iconv. So if we look at the man page, let's look at man1p, we can then see that this is the man page for the POSIX programmer's manual, and looking at how we might convert from one format to another format. Let's just quit out of this, so hitting the Q key. One of the things though included within the locale is the sort format. So here in my test directory, I can see that I've got apple and apple, banana and banana, but we can see we've mixed the case around. But the lowercase apple and uppercase apple are close to each other, the same as the banana. But if I change my locale, so if we do something like this, where we set the current lang to an old lang variable, just so we've got it stored and ready for reuse later on. And some of this we could consider even doing through a script. Let's just double check it. So if I go through now and echo out old lang, woohoo, it's all looking good. So now let's go through and change our variable so we can export lang. And if we set it through to POSIX, so we could use POSIX, or you'll see later, we could also use C, that these values become very much more at the heart of Linux, and we can see the sort order is changed here. When I run the ls command now, we can see that our uppercase apple and banana are together and our lowercase values are together. We can use this ourselves for some benefit, perhaps for sorting, but also sometimes if we set this in scripts where we know we have to exchange information between different organizations or part of our organizations where we might have character encoding difficulties, at least this way we know we can be using a very similar character set. Let's just change this back. So if I go now and lang equals old lang, and then we just export our lang so it's available to subshells. I say one way of doing it would be using POSIX as our catch-all, but because the operating system itself was written in C, we could also consider setting our language variable to uppercase C, and this has a similar sort of effect as POSIX, so we can see everything is sorted in the same way, but again just becomes that general catch-all to try and avoid some of the problems, particularly in pipelining and scripts, that process information between different systems. So that's it for this presentation, and I look forward to seeing you back on the Urban Penguin channel again very soon. But good luck in your LPI Level 1 certification, and I do hope my videos help.